So let's move to the next question. Question number
53.
Done. Energy of the colliding photon is it? Oh, that much noise is coming. Okay, so energy of the colliding photon is 10.2 electron volt. After an interval, another photon collides with the same hydrogen atom inelastically with the two photons, EP1, EP2, 15 electron volt. What will be observed by the detector? Where is the detector? It doesn't talk about the detector, but detector will detect the photons that are coming out of hydrogen atom. Let's assume that. Okay, so how you're getting 3?
So because the second photon has 15 electron volt and ionizing energy for hydrogen atom is about 13.6 electron volts. So it obviously has to kick out one electron because it's...
Correct.
So I think it, only one option talks about an electron.
See, electron will need how much energy to get ionized? 13.6, not minus. Minus 13.6 is its energy. It requires plus 13.6 to make its energy zero, total energy. But if it get more energy, then it will take 13.6 and rest of it will be used as kinetic energy. Getting it? So that electron that comes out will have energy of 15 minus 13.6, which is 1.4. Okay. And of course, when the first photon strikes, the... You know the difference between the first energy level and the second energy level is what? The ground state and the first energy level. What is the difference? 10.2. So exactly this much energy will be absorbed and the electron will jump from n equal to 1 to n equal to 2 from the first photon itself. Alright? And then when it gets de-excited, it will create a photon of same energy, 10.2. Okay, that's why option number 3 is correct, right? Now, you know, this is little confusing also because at times you will tend to think, okay, this 15 electron volt can be absorbed by the electron which is already excited.
But there's a time.
Okay, but the time interval is microsecond. It happens instantaneously. It will jump to n equal to 2, and once there is only one photon, jumps there and immediately will come down. Very, very less amount of time. So there is a time. Okay. Start solving this. Here you may not know the formula for characteristic X-ray. This is the formula. Okay. This is not hydrogen like atom, but the formula looks similar to that. But then there is a factor of B. B is a screening constant. What happens is that these electrons will get screened because of the inner orbital. You know what is screening effect?
Yeah.
Right? So effectively it behaves like a lesser atomic number. So that is a Z minus B. And for alpha, let's say for K alpha, the value of B is equal to 1. Screening constant is 1 for K alpha radiations.
So when do we take this formula? Right?
When you have to find characteristic X-ray.
Six.
Where
do you
think
K alpha? Right, so the first formula is 1 by lambda is Rydberg constant, Z minus B is 11 minus 1, that is 10 square. N1, for alpha, N1 is 1, okay. This is N2 square. And for other atomic number, let's say it is this. So it will be Rydberg constant Z minus B whole square. So you can just divide these two. You can divide these two, you'll get the value of Z. Okay? The value of B over here is 1. Okay? Z is equal to 6, all of you? 55. I'll tell you. First focus on 55. You should watch that video. Okay? Everything is there. Otherwise, we'll just keep on talking in bits and pieces. It'll never make sense complete. Watch that. B. Others. What is the fringe width? What happens to wavelength if velocity increases? It decreases because h by p is the wavelength. When you decrease the wavelength, fringe width will decrease. That's why 3. Okay? Okay. No doubts, right? Go to the next one. Option 3. You move to the next one. Others. You didn't get 56? Huh? Helium has to get converted into oxygen. Okay. Helium has atomic number of oxygen. So you need 4 heliums. And there will be energy. Energy is nothing but kinetic energy of oxygen only. Okay. So delta M is what? 4 into 4.00. See, these types you should get it, okay? This shows that you came completely unprepared or you are unnecessarily overconfident about yourself. So you should give the due respect to this chapter.
can become 10 times.
Huh. 931 MeV is the energy released if one AMU gets converted into energy. So you find out the mass effect in AMU and multiply it with 931. Okay. Fine. 57, what is the answer? Anybody else? Any answer? Okay. Now half-life of A is 4 days. Probability that the nucleus will decay in 2 half-life. Okay. Now what is the probability that it doesn't decay? Then it should be in, let's say, in 2 half-life, N0 will become?
N0 by 4.
N0 will become N0 by 4.
Yeah.
Okay. So if it doesn't have to decay, it should be out of N0, it should be N0 by 4. So probability that it doesn't decay is 1 by 4. There is probability that it doesn't decay. So 1 minus of that is a probability that it will decay.
Yeah.
That is 3 by 4. See, it's like if a particular nucleus doesn't decay, then it has to be these N0 by 4, one of these N0 by 4 nucleus, right? If it doesn't want to get decayed. What is the chance that it will be N0 by 4 out of N0? 1 by 4? That is the probability that it will not decay. There are only two mutually exclusive and exhaustive events, whether it will decay or not decay. So 1 minus of probability that it will not decay is probability that it will decay, right? And of course the probability will be very high that after 2 half-lives, it will, the probability should be high. Probability cannot be 1, right? And probability cannot be 1 by 4, very less probability. And half is like exactly half, it should be more. You know, like that also you can arrive if you start thinking in that way, but you can't do that with each and every question. And this type of thing will be done only by those who have a lot of practice. It can't be like you just develop this, you know, sixth sense on your own just sitting. Do a lot of practice, it will come automatically. Okay, we'll move to the next one. Which question is this? Fifty-eight, and this is 59. Thank you. again that knowledge will be used. Lyman. Lyman is for UV.
Yeah.
And Pastion is for infrared. Lyman is the first quantum number should be 1, and Pastion the first quantum number should be 3. Lyman is this minus 1 by n square, where n is greater than 1, right? Now this is largest wavelength in UV region. Now when lambda is largest, 1 by lambda should be smallest. So what is the smallest possible? What is the value of n for that? 2, right? So 1 by lambda 1 is Rydberg constant into 1 by 1 minus 1 by 2 square, which is 4. So this will be equal to 3 by 4 Rydberg constant. This is the first equation. Okay. Then this is given 122. Now smallest possible region in IR zone. Now let's say IR zone is when N1 is 3. So this is 1 by 9 minus 1 by M square, where M is greater than 3, right? Now I want smallest possible wavelength. So 1 by lambda should be largest. 1 by lambda infinity?
So,
so 1 by lambda should be maximum. And when 1 by lambda is maximum, this subtraction should be minimum. So for that M should be infinity. It get ionized from there. So this will be equal to Rydberg constant by 9. This is equation number 2. Now just take a ratio, you'll get lambda 1, lambda 2 relation, and then like that, you can do it. 59.
So why do we get the relation
of, you know, Rydberg constant, you multiply by n, and then you get lambda 2, right? Why have they given the first data?
It
would be tedious. That's a nice question. Yeah, they can directly calculate also.
But R value won't be 4 by
122. What? I mean,
the R value which
you'll
find from the first expression won't be the
actual R value. I mean,
it isn't.
This is
just a hypothetical scenario then. Okay. 59th, look at the 59th question. You're able to see, right?
Yeah.
What is the answer? So uranium-236 is unstable. It gives out products, right? So it gives energy also. Okay. So E is what? Rest mass energy. Rest mass energy is E. So in a way, it denotes, let's say, it corresponds to the mass. Okay. It corresponds to the mass of that substance. Now, reactant is more stable or product is more stable here? Product is more stable. So sum of the rest masses of the product should be less than the sum of sum of the rest masses of the reactants. Okay. So that is the reason why option number 1 is correct. Some mass will get converted into energy. Okay. What is the difference between 2, 3 and 4? Oh, okay.
2, 3 masses.
Different products are coming out. Okay. All right. Should we move to next one? All of these are previous year JEE questions. Like long, long back starting when you were not even born. Even I was not born. Very long back, I am very old. What? Okay, 40. I'm 40.
She is asking how old Ben was JEE started.
40 years, probably. Close to. Yeah, 40. 40. Okay, do this. This 60th. 61. Who do you think is older, me or Akhil? Akhil is older. I mean, not like that. As in.
Okay.
It's getting recorded. I'll show it. Chalo. See, the X-ray questions are very frequent. You can't afford to ignore it. Simply cannot. Done? What is the answer for 60th? No answer. It can't be as simple as this, right? And dimensionally, all three are different. And h by momentum is dimension of wavelength. H by mc is wavelength. So dimensionally 2 is correct and 1 is correct. 3 is also correct. All are dimensionally correct. There is no shortcut. Okay. So electrons with deep Rayleigh wavelength lambda fall on a target in X-ray tube. Fine. So deep Rayleigh wavelength is lambda, so momentum is what? H by lambda. You need to find cutoff wavelength of the emitted X-ray. Cutoff wavelength is minimum wavelength. Now can you find out? Total energy of electron should get converted into photon. That's when the cutoff voltage, cutoff wavelength will come out. Should I do it? energy of the electron is what? P square by 2ME, which is H square by 2 mass of electron into wavelength. Okay, this should get converted into H C by lambda naught. So 3 comes out.
So H can and lambda.
So lambda naught is 2ME lambda square C H. Option 1. What about 61? Which of the statements is wrong? Look at the second option. Is it true? Between 2 and 4, only one can be true. So it is between 2 and 4. So you should be diligent enough to at least remove two options.
So you're saying that 2 and 4 is true.
1 and 4 is wrong. Which one is correct? Okay. Okay. Okay.
Which one is wrong?
2.
2 is wrong. Right? Right, it depends on the energy of the electron. It doesn't depend on the atomic number. Characteristic X-ray depends on atomic number. Okay, we'll move to the next one. Not many are left. Think 10 or 15 only.
Do both of them quickly. 63 is 4.
62, first one. See, for 62, radioactive sample S1 has twice number of nuclei. So let's say S1 has N naught, or let's say 2 N naught is for S1, then N naught will be for S2. So let's say lambda 1 is rate constant for S1. So lambda 1 into 2 N naught is dN by dt for S1, which is 5 micro curie. Whatever is conversion factor, let's keep it like this only. 5 into some conversion factor K. Okay. This is lambda 1, and then lambda 2 into N naught should be equal to
10
into conversion factor K. Okay. Now divide them. You'll get 2 times lambda 1 by lambda 2 should be equal to 1 by 2. Okay. So you'll get lambda 2 is equal to 4 times of lambda 1. Okay. Now half life is what?
0.65 by lambda 1.
Half life is proportional to 1 by lambda. Okay. So basically 1 by lambda 1 is equal to 4 by lambda 2. Okay. So half life of the first one is 4 times the half life of the second one. It should be the case. So it says it can be, it may or may not be, but only option 1 satisfied that condition where half-life of first is 4 times the other. You can just multiply 0.693 here, 0.693 there. Okay. Okay, 63rd. Fourth one? How many fourth? Saimir? You can't see. You can see? You can see? Your power has increased. You will become more powerful now. Come sit here, front. Put it down. Okay, so you have attempted all of you, right? So all of you, many of you in 4, which is wrong. You get minus 1. Okay, now first of all understand one thing, that you have 3 different metal plates. Okay, light beam has these 3 wavelengths, equal intensities, illuminates each of the plates. Now you may tend to think that all intensity is same, so current is proportional to intensity, so whatever current comes out should be same saturation current. But what if 550 nanometer wavelength is not good enough to take electron out from work function of 3 electron volt? So that intensity is meaningless. Getting it? Okay. Now if you want to check, what you should check? You should just check for the longest possible wavelength and the largest work function. If this wavelength is able to take out electron from here, then everything will come out. All the wavelengths will create electrons from all the surfaces. Okay, but you will see that this will come around 2.2 something. So this wavelength will not be able to take out electrons from Q and R, only from P it will be able to take out. And similarly, when you check, this wavelength will not be able to take out electrons from phi R, but from P and Q it will be able to take out, and this one will be able to take out from all 3. Getting it? That is why intensity for P will be most, then Q, then R. Okay, you can check, let's say for 550 nanometer, what is the energy of a particular photon? 6.6 10 to the power minus 34 H C.
Current intensity
represents similar thing, number. it is number only. One is number per unit area, another is number per second. Number and charge. Okay, so Hc by charge of electron 1.6 into 10 to the minus 19 into lambda. Hc by lambda is 5.5 into 10 to the power 7, minus 7, sorry. Okay, so this, gone. Okay, this is approximately 4 times, let's say 4.1. Okay. Then it will come out to be 12.3 divided by 5.5. Okay, this is definitely not 3 and not even 2.5. This is close to 2.3 electron volts, close to that. Okay. Exactly how much it is. Okay, so now this is the energy of photon. Will it be able to take out electrons from this metal? No. So this intensity is useless for R and for Q also. It will only be taking out electrons from P. But if this is able to take out electrons from P, all the wavelengths will be able to take out electrons from P, because all the wavelengths are lesser and their frequencies are higher. Similarly, you will see that, so P should be highest. P should be highest, okay? And once you get this information, then this doesn't make sense. This doesn't make sense. P cannot be lowest. Even this is gone. Just take one and move ahead. You don't need to now check for... What?
If it can take all the three metals, then if the wavelength is high enough, then which graph will it
be? See, if 550 is good enough to take electrons from 3 electron volts, then all the wavelengths will be able to take out from electrons from 3 electron volts. And if all wavelengths can take electrons from 3, all wavelengths will be able to take out electrons from these two also. So it will be between 2 and 4, it will be 2. Okay, there's a dip because electrons get decelerated from P. Kinetic energy of electrons will be higher, so they need more push to decelerate. I mean, they need more negative voltage because their kinetic energy will be higher. Fine, we'll move to the next one. You should bring a recorded and then play it after every notorious class 11th, right? You guys were like this in 11th? Some of them are pretty good class 11thers, some of them like Bharat and Sukhit. You know them? Bharat, you might be known. He just dances around. Everything is recorded. Not this one. Start doing. Don't wait for me to put another question. Oh, question from EM wave. This is which question? 60? Done. Option 2 for 64.
Option
1. Approximately 2 kya hota hai? Approximately 2. Waha pe half fill karke aayega to the bubble.
Answer is very close to option 1.
Balmer series for hydrogen atom, 1 by 2 square, the first spectral line is this, and the wavelength of the second spectral line in the Balmer series of singly ionized helium atom, lambda 1, for helium, Z is 2, so this is 4 times. Second spectral line, so 1 by 4 squares.
Yeah.
Just divide it. Okay, getting close to this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. 65.
No,
I haven't taught this.
I know the formula. Is it E naught by B naught is equal to C or B naught?
You tell me.
C naught by B naught.
Ah. So remember this, although I'll take a class on EM waves soon, before your JEE Mains, I'll take all of you together, all 12thers online. This is speed of light, magnitude of electric field in EM wave divided by amplitude of magnetic field in EM wave will be equal to speed of light.
So what does N stand for?
28. Nano. Okay, fine. So you'll get the answer. What answer are you getting? 6. Okay. So this is E naught by 20 into. This is 3 × 10⁸ speed of light. Okay. All right. Let's take a couple of more. Should the video get edited before uploading, or is it like this fine? Because when it gets edited, immediately after the question is shown, solution will be shown. That pause will get removed. Pause is required, right? Because it will feel like a class, you can move with the pace. Fine, so my load is reduced. Okay, anybody got the answer? None. Should I do it? There you go. This formula you might be remembering. Okay. And you might be knowing this formula also. Okay. So M into V is QBR. Okay. So half MV square is half of Q square, B square, R square by M. Fine. Now it talks about the largest possible radius, right? Now large, if R is largest possible, then the kinetic energy will be largest possible. They are directly proportional. Okay. So from here you get K max. Okay. We need to find work function, and this H into mu is the energy that corresponds to 3-2 transition in hydrogen atom. Right, so H into mu should be equal to what? Energy in the third orbit minus energy in the second orbit. Right, so minus 13.6 divided by 3 square minus of.
Is it better to leave this question?
Yeah, I'm coming to that. So H into mu is this. Okay, but this is in electron volts. So better is to find kinetic energy in electron volts. How do you find? Just divide with charge of electron. So basically Q is also E. Q is E only, right? So one Q get cancelled off. Okay, so like that it will get simplified a bit, and then just substitute value of H mu and K max. Will get the value of phi in electron volts, because you can look at the options also. Options are in terms of electron volts, so it makes sense to find everything in electron volts. Okay, so if you encounter this question initially when you have a lot of time to attempt in question paper, leave it till the end. Don't start fighting with questions which are eating up your time, otherwise you'll be under a lot of pressure because time will just go away. Okay, so immediately when you feel that some question will just eat up your time, and but then you know how to solve it, keep a note of it, that if you get time towards the end, you will attempt this. Okay. Initially you should only solve questions which you are getting easily. That will boost your confidence. Okay. All right, move to the next one. Why?
Is sense.
Option 3, right?
Yeah.
Because atomic number for hydrogen deuterium is same. So lambda 1 No, wait. Rydberg constant will be double for deuterium, right? Mass is double. We discussed that.
But none of the other options are not so
same. None of the other options are 9.
9. But if you consider helium and all, so if for that also Rydberg constants should change.
Yeah, it changes, right?
That sense.
Z square is coming. But the deuterium mass is changing. So we are not putting 2 square there. But we are putting just 2. Corresponding to mass. Like for helium, it comes 4. Anyways, right now we'll go with 3rd because that's the only thing which aligns with everything else. We'll come back to this. Okay, I'll just put another question here itself. One. Why? Because if it is forward bias, this side should be higher voltage than that side. Okay. So you may have a.
Yeah, because signs are.
Signs are same. But sign itself is relative. You assume some potential is zero. If you assume this is zero potential, this becomes minus. See, this becomes minus 2 volts. Because zero potential is an assumption. Sixty-nine. Able to see, right?
Yeah.
You know, while I was taking JEE, light went off. Light went off, but it was a daytime. But the problem was that it was light. I mean, there were so many lights, and it was a room. It was an auditorium. Like I think around 1,000 people were sitting there. So it was closed. All right, and when light is too much, and suddenly light goes off, you'll feel. Darkness for at least for some 10 seconds, okay, and then on top of it you're not getting any problem. It's a stressful situation. It is good idea to remember H into C value in terms of electron volt. So you can remember 1240 electron volt nanometer. Thank you.
2.6 electrons.
Okay. So you'll have two equations like this. All of you got these two?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is like. So you just take the ratio. You'll get hc by lambda 1 minus phi divided by hc by lambda 2 minus phi. This is Km1 by Km2. What is the ratio of Km1 by Km2?
4 is to 1.
Yeah. Velocity, mass is same.
Yeah.
So U1 square by U2 square is ratio of the kinetic energy. So this is 4 is to 1.
3.7.
Okay. So H into C is 1240. Stop talking. Divided by lambda 1 is 248 minus 5 divided by 1240, then 310 minus 5 is equal to 4. Okay, so just solve this. What answer you are getting?
3.7.
See, first get phi is equal to something and then simplify it. Don't start simplifying here only that what is 1240 divided by 248. First get what is phi is equal to.
3.7
you are getting?
Yes.
Okay, good. Alright, so last question for today. Question number 70. So we have done good number of practice. Questions again, X-ray. All the formulas I have already told you. What?
B will be
for alpha, for k alpha, B is 1. You remember that formula?
Yes.
1 by lambda is equal to Rydberg constant z minus 1. This is for k alpha radiation. And for k alpha, n1 is 1. K shell, n is 1, K, L, M, N, fine. K alpha is from L to K, K beta is from M to K. What is L alpha? From M to L. Watch that video. You think?
No.
Think se thodi hoga.
Calculation is approximate.
What is the answer? This is the last question. Get it right, all of you. Don't use calculator and just do the hand calculation. Then only you tell me the answer. Homework is whether you have taken mock test or not. Circulate that sheet again.
Last.
Yeah, two mock tests have circulated, right?
Yes.
You write what you have done with those.
Option
2?
Yeah. Option
2. 2.
Yes.
Lambda Cu is X-ray of copper, lambda MO. Lambda Cu is Rydberg constant, z minus 1 for copper is 28 square, N1 is 1. But then that I don't think will be used here. 1 by lambda molybdenum is Rydberg constant into 42 minus 1, 41 square, 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. Fine. So this is first and this is second. So lambda MO divided by lambda CU is 28 by 41 whole square, but reverse is asked. So 41 by 28 whole square, this is what is asked. Okay. Now, you know, definitely you'll see that it's not 3 and 4. Okay. It's between 1 and 2 and they're very close.
And it's almost 1.5. So you can take it as 40 by 28.
So this is, you have to do hand calculations here because these two options are very close.
7 fours
what?
Almost 7 6 are.
Oh, like that. So, but then you should remember that whatever answer you get, it should be slightly less than that. There's 2, this is 1.5 square. 1.5 square is
2.25.
So, slightly less than that. 2.14. Yeah, it should be 2.14. Let me confirm that. Yes, 2.14. Fine, so that's it for modern physics problem solving. I think we have taken all sorts of questions. You guys have to watch that X-ray video, okay? And make sure your modern physics, then optics, then thermodynamics, then magnetism, EMI. These are very, very strong for you because mechanics, you may think that you are enjoying solving it, but it may ditch you at any moment. But if you are good at modern physics, 90% chance you will get it right. Okay? Bye.